What's up, guys? Frank here with Teloch and Ghul of Mayhem. First of all, I have to say congratulations on your upcoming new record, Daemon. It is visceral and fucking nasty. I personally feel that it kind of ventures back into some earlier sounds and tones of the band.
For sure, yeah, for sure.
And you know, I don't know if this is the reason or not, but I know, you know, only 2 years ago, you just got off tour from doing Demysterious, and it was a very global thing.
That's a very astute observation, actually, that is massively influential to how, you know, we played the Demysterious album 200 times live. So of course, then we started to write immediately after that.
Right.
It's kind of so of course it bleeds through into the, yeah, so yeah, well spotted.
No, and of course, you guys are known as true Norwegian black metal, which is kind of funny because you're spread across three different countries now.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah.
How did you manage the songwriting and rehearsal process? Because I know that this is also a first for where you're both writing on this one.
Yeah. We basically worked alone, generated ideas, and then came together in Oslo to rehearse and try ideas. And so it was kind of like a two-stage process. Come up with ideas, get together, realize none of it works, go away, come back with new ideas, and just repeat until we ended up with, what was it, 12 songs in the
end? Yeah, something like that. There was a very long process.
I think it was well done, well put, it worked out. Did you ever think Mayhem would actually be like a record, a file sharing type situation? You know,
it was always a goal to do something like this, and I think this is the first step to do it even more on the next one.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, it's a really cool process. Everyone was involved. It's a joint effort.
Yeah, it was weirdly positive actually for this band. It was strangely unified. You know, very little arguing. And, I guess that's just part of what happens when you've been playing together for so long, with such extensive touring. Something naturally just happens creatively. You feel the click, and you just start to anticipate other people's moves, you know, and it becomes a more natural process. So.
Yeah, absolutely.
And, you know, the new album actually came out to be one of the most dissonant, eerie, unsettling things I've heard in a long time.
Right.
You know, considering that you were both had your hand in the writing process, was it a challenge to find the right tone for where you wanted to take it?
I mean, we threw away an unbelievable amount of material.
Yeah.
So yeah, it was definitely draining. But
the whole goal for the album was to make it very simple and back to the roots in a way,
yeah.
But not any specific album, but just back to the roots and back to the old school kind of thing.
It's innocent writing, like what Teloch said in the early stages. We have to try to write as if we don't know anything. You know, we're just teenagers on the guitar, and we're just you know, trying to make some music. And that's exactly how we approached it.
Now, of course, I've seen you guys live so many times in the past few years, the most recently at Beyond the Gates Festival, such an incredible set, in Bergen, but yeah, an incredible set, kind of like a double atmosphere type thing that you had going on. And you know, every time I see you guys, it's apparent that you become a very different persona on stage. You know, you guys really stop being, you know, you and become Teloch and Ghul. Can you tell us the feeling or the thoughts that go through your head as you step on stage with Mayhem and become that persona?
There's no thought, really, for me. It's an honest, it's not a character, it's like a subsection of my consciousness, you know what I mean? It's like a boxed off area that I can't use in a day-to-day life because I'd be in jail, you know?
Right.
It's just an easy switch for me, at least, is how I see it.
I always thought about it like going into war in a way,
like a parachute drop or something, like a combat drop. When their intro's going, you get that adrenaline.
No, but I don't know, you transform somehow, either way, if you don't think about it or not, you will transform into something else, like this character, I guess. because it's so much easier to play and try to be evil in a different person, because if you be yourself, then it's just...
You feel awkward and...
Yeah.
It's not a natural thing, but...
Are there moments where you laugh on stage and be yourself for a moment?
Yeah.
Unfortunately, yes.
Absolutely.
Yeah, there's always things. A lot of the time it's stuff that people in the crowd won't notice, but there's always times when we, you know, you look at each other and like, all right.
Yeah, if someone plays mistakes and shit,
then it's just laughing out loud, actually.
Yeah, but those are momentary things, and then you slip back into the moment. You know?
Right, yeah, always.
Now, of course, Mayhem is a band that's so chronicled. People are always talking about it. What is something that most people may not know or believe about the band?
I think people would be surprised. I think Mayhem has a sort of legacy of being like very hated by certain aspects of the metal community, because people have a very strange idea of what we actually are. And actually, I think people would be surprised to spend any time with us and realize they're actually pretty okay people. You know, we're not like hateful, we're not Nazis, we're not, you know, any of the shit that gets thrown at us very regularly. And we're actually pretty kind of liberalist, decent people who are just musicians, you know. We're all flawed, don't get me wrong, heavily, but you know, we're decent people, and even though we're followed around by a lot of very negative stuff, there's a lot of negativity, but it's productive negativity, and it's certainly not the really shitty stuff that often comes at us.
Right.
With accusation.
What do you get thrown at with the most?
Like misspoke interviews and this kind of stuff. But the reality is very different. Our fan base is a very eclectic mix of people. And we're very welcoming to all of them. And they know that. And you know, we have extremely hardcore fans from every walk of life. And that's something that I think is maybe surprising to some people.
Right. Yeah, that's true. I always put, you know, Mayhem is synonymous with extremity, you know, so I expect all the weird, craziest shit from you guys.
That's definitely true. There's no fakery there. It's a bunch of extreme people.
But also when it comes to the extreme stuff, it's so normal for us, so we don't think about the extreme
Absolutely.
Things.
When we're on tour and then you go home and you're still in that mind, the Mayhem mind, you need like 5 days before you can go to the shop, because you just can't be that person.
Now, you guys have been in the band for quite a while. I think you're coming up like 7-8 years or something like that, right?
It's about 8 years for you. I think it's about 9, something like that.
Yes.
So it's been quite a while. What is something that you've learned about yourself through being in Mayhem?
Nothing good.
How stupid can it be, you know, being in a band like this for all that time?
Right. I remember when I learned something about myself when Attila came to me. When I first came to the band, he was always apologizing for everything, you know. He would come to me all the time like, oh, fuck, man, I'm so sorry that it's like this. And, you know, you must think we're totally idiotic. And then one day he came to me and he was like, you're just as much of an idiot. And then I realized, wow, okay. I don't know how to take that, but to fit into this band is... I don't know if it's a good thing or
bad. You have to be very patient, I guess, and that's getting more and more clearer to me that I'm a very patient guy.
Right. It's a very special kind of person that can survive in this band. You can take that how you want.
And of course, last but not least, there's been a whole lot of attention this year with the band in particular because of Lords of Chaos and, you know, the output of that. My question is, as guys who came into the band later in the story, has that any effect on you?
No, not at all. Don't think about it. It's nothing to do with us. Nothing to do with the band. It's not. I mean, Necro, of course, that's like... He was there, it was his thing. He doesn't give a fuck about it either. That's something someone else is doing. It's got nothing really to do with what we're doing. It's nothing to do with the music. It's gossip. It's bullshit. No.
Is there a day that you hope people stop talking about it?
That's never going to happen. It's part of the band's history. And it's an interesting story, you know.
It's very important for the band
of course,
as well,
yeah.
But, you know, we get tired from hearing about it.
Yeah, so, right. But at the same time, you have to accept that's part of the foundation of everything.
So. Well, it's all about the new stuff. Daemon is out this Friday. Check it out. These guys shred.